Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for coming for this lecture. As you're aware, it's a part of initiative of Athletic Insights. Athletic Insights is an initiative started by Pune Running, and Nalanda, Samir Sheikh, and Colonel Pitre are the ones who have started this initiative. Objective is basically to have, conduct talks and some sort of an knowledge sharing, or maybe you can say view sharing on running. It's for beginners, it's for people who have been into running, is it audible? Or the people who want to improve on their running. And this is the third session in that series. They had two in the past, and the third one they have specifically chosen to do it on women and running. The reason for having it on women and running is because the fairer sex is very poorly represented in running. That's what the men feel. And so we thought that we should do something to encourage and to get more number of people into just not just running, but any outdoor activity, sport. So while we have chosen this platform of Pune Running to say that, okay, let's start running, it is actually applies to any fitness or any sports activity or any outdoor activity that you choose to do. Women are very poorly represented in all of these activities, not just in India, but outside, but specifically in India. While we do not, we cannot claim ourselves to be a very healthy nation, and particularly not if we are the highest number of diabetic people in our country, and women are also prone to osteoporosis and various other things. Most of it can be avoided by a healthy lifestyle, and the first thing for a healthy lifestyle is definitely to get fit. Not that you need to be fit as an athlete, but at least something for yourself which is just good enough to keep you healthy, keep you active. And therefore, we thought that let's have people, or rather women from different backgrounds who have managed to pursue any kind of sports activity, whether it is due to, across the age group. So we have someone representing college-going girl, we have someone like Professor Bhave, who is 66 and still going strong with running and cycling. We have somebody who has an as active career like a neurologist, and yet she has managed to pursue sports and her liking for it. And we of course have Zia, who has fought with an illness, and yet she has run a full marathon in something like 4 hours and 40 minutes, which is absolutely commendable. So we will, instead of me introducing you all of them individually, we'll just play a clipping one by one for all of them, so that you get to know a little more about themselves from themselves. And then I'll hand over the mic to Manjiri, who is going to conduct the panel discussion. Basically, we just want to know that how is it that they started with the running or any other sport activity? How did they pursue? How they keep themselves motivated? And if it can inspire, not that I see a whole lot of audience here, then if it can inspire a few of us to take up any physical activity to keep fit, I think it would have served the purpose for today's talk. So let's play the clipping. We'll play for Bhave Madam first.
Me Nirupama Bhave. Atta 66 varsha sampat alay. आणि बाय प्रोफेशन मी प्रोफेसर आहे मॅथमॅटिक्सची. रिटायर होऊन 4-5 वर्ष झाली, आणि 10 वर्षापूर्वी मला एकदम क्लिक झालं की आपण आता अकॅडमिक्समधून इकडे फिजिकल याच्यामध्ये पडावं, आणि मग मला एकदम सायकल चालवायला सुरुवात करावीशी वाटली, आणि मग त्यातून मी या ग्रुपमध्येच येऊन पडले. म्हणजे सायकलिंग केलं, मग ट्रेकिंग केलं, मग ह्याला जिमला जाण्याचे फायदे कळले, मग जॉगिंग रनिंग असं सगळे त्याचे मला फायदे, आणि खरंचच फिटनेस वगैरे इतका छान राहतो. सकाळचा 1.5 तास वेळ इतका मस्त जातो, आणि दिवसभर आपण ॲक्टिव्ह राहतो.
हॅलो एव्हरीबडी, आय एम डॉक्टर अवंती बिनीवाले, अँड आय एम वर्किंग ॲज अ कन्सल्टंट न्यूरॉलॉजिस्ट इन पुणे. आय बीन इन टू ॲक्टिव्ह क्लिनिकल प्रॅक्टिस, मेडिकल प्रॅक्टिस फॉर द पास्ट 35 इयर्स, अँड डिस्पाईट the demands of my profession, I've managed to stay into sport all these years. I started off swimming during childhood, and at that time we used to participate in the nationals, and it was competitive swimming, but I managed to keep on swimming and maintain the fitness throughout my pregnancy, through the delivery, through my children, and also during my career as training for medical school. The swimming has continued, but apart from that, I've also developed a liking for trekking and cycling, and this was basically through participating in enduro, which is an adventure race of its only kind held in India. I still participate in Masters National Aquatic Championships and have managed to do so for the past 6 consecutive years. In fact, I've just returned from Rajkot National Masters Swimming Championships. What I would like to impart through this is that despite the demands of work, pressure, family responsibilities, children, it is possible to keep a physical activity if you make it a point to find the time for it. It is very essential because it keeps the brain alert, it keeps you fit, physically fit, takes away days of illness from your from the months that you put in, and it gives a feeling of well-being altogether. Age is no bar really, because I'm 50 now and I can still run. It is important to develop a proper technique of running, and that can come through coaching from a proper coach. Basically, what I would like to say is that when there is a will, there is a way, and it is possible to follow all sorts of physical activities throughout your life, and there are people running at 80 and 90. A busy woman always has time and a lazy woman has no time. So I hope after this, most of you will pick up some form of physical activity, hopefully running, and happy running.
Both of them did not really talk of what they have achieved so far, and therefore I would like to say that Avanti has been a gold medalist swimmer throughout, and I think in World Medi Games she has represented India, and she has been a gold medalist for almost 6 years. She has been winning other various competitions, like she mentioned enduro. She just won the Satara Marathon recently, which was in Satara in her age group, and Pune Bicycle Championship. I mean, I think the time will not be enough if I have to read out all of it. Even Professor Bhave, she at the age of, when did you do Khardungla? Okay, so when she was 60 years, she decided to cycle up from Manali to Leh up to Khardungla, which is the highest motorable road. So, you know, like both of them mentioned that if there is a will, there is a way. And when we were talking to Mrs. Bhave before, so I just asked her, why do you think there are so few women in running? So she just said, khara sangu ka alshi asta. So while she wouldn't mention that here, I thought it's apt to make a mention of that. We can please.
Hi, my name is Zia Cheney, and I have I'm a mother of two little girls who are 10 and 7, and I've been running for I think for the last 2 years seriously, long distance running. I've always been an athlete. I've always been running and going to the gym, and you know, basic fitness levels have been good actually, I would say. And the turning point in my life was 3 years ago when I was detected with breast cancer. So that was in 2010. I found a lump quite by accident, and as it turned out, I had breast cancer, which I had to obviously get, you know, go in for surgery and chemotherapy. That was what actually made me realize the importance of being really fit and healthy, because after my chemo, when I tried going back onto the treadmill and running, I couldn't even run longer than say 5 minutes, and that, you know, kind of gave me the impetus, you know, to say to kind of take my health to another level, where, you know, no disease or illness could ever, you know, debilitate me in any way. And so I decided that I wanted to run the Mumbai full marathon. And I joined a group called the Pune Marathoners Club, and with their support, with a group of 30 other like-minded people of different ages and you know, men and women, we started training for 4 months. I think I started for 4 months, and finally, I mean, you know, I ran the Mumbai Marathon this year, earlier this year in January, and I ran the 42 kilometers in 4 hours 40 minutes. It was an amazing experience. But I must say that the journey was even more fun than the actual race, because I not only made really good friends, but I realized so much about myself that, you know, if you really focus on something, if you really want something, you can actually achieve it. And I proved that by, you know, doing the marathon.
Hi, I'm Prachi Gondi. I'm a mother of two who also likes to run. So I just wanted to talk to you about how I got into running. This is before I had my kids. Around 2004 is when I first got into running because of some friends. And I trained and ran my first half marathon. And of course it was much easier at that point. I was much younger. And then of course life got in the way. I had one kid after another. And that took a few years out and I had to stop. Then again I decided that I wanted to start doing it, and get fit again. And then again life got in the way and I had an accident and tore my ligament. So again that took another year out of my life. And somewhere around that same time I came across the Pune Running page on Facebook. And I thought, why not try and start with these people. And so last November, November 30th is when I did my first run with Pune Running, and I barely managed to finish the 5K. My goal at that point was to just run the whole time, and I achieved that goal. So it's been one full year almost of running with a great group of people, and I've enjoyed every bit of it. And now I have moved up to 15 kilometers, which I can do, which I have the confidence in doing now. So, and I want to keep on doing this. I enjoy this, and I would like to tell everyone that it is possible to do it, even if you have little kids. If you have a great support system, you can do this, and you have a great group of runners here in Pune. So they are definitely there to help you out. And so, yeah, that's how I am, where I am. And the goal is to eventually do a half marathon and maybe at some point do a full marathon. But I'm taking it slow and easy. So that's all about me. And I can talk to you more in detail about this maybe at the panel. So thanks.
Hello everyone, my name is Manisha Gurmal. I'm a student. I'm cursing my MSc from Ferguson College in Biotech, and I run. The thing is, I started running all because my sir inspired me. Actually, he just asked me once, okay, like, we are running in university, so would you like to come? And that time I thought that, okay, I'll be running only 5 kilometers. But even I was not knowing about it, when like I completed something around 12 kilometers. And I was actually amazed, okay, yes, I can do 12. And that time when I stopped, that time I just felt as if, okay, fine, even the 1-2 kilometers more might have not never mattered. So from that time, I actually started running. And from the like that time it was like I started running only on Sundays, and after that, after some like then August I guess, we had a marathon. It is a Hyderabad marathon, and that I ran 21. And that time my dad don't like these things. So still what had happened, ki like I was not able to control when I did that 21, and after that I immediately registered for Mumbai. And Hyderabad experience was seriously awesome. I never thought that I'll be able to run 21, but I ran without any complaint.
Good evening to all of you. My name is Manjiri, and I thank Shilpa for taking us through the first bit of it. We are moving on to the panel discussion part of it. I think we have one hands-free mic, so I'm going to give it up to the ladies to make use of it while I use this one up here. We're going to just have a discussion. They're going to be talking to y'all. We have a little flow that we have decided on. And at the end of it, at the tail end, we leave it up to y'all in case you want to pose any questions to them as well. Right? At the offset, I'd like to request y'all to please put your phones on silent. If some of you haven't done it already, if y'all can do that, that would be a big favor. Thank you so much. Okay. I think we'll first start with the first bit of it, which is how each one of you got motivated to get into running. I think, Bhavya ma'am, I'm going to pose the first question to you. That of the entire lot sitting on the stage right now, you are one individual who started cycling and running at the very prime young age of 56, and you've been doing it for the last 10 years, and you've been doing it so fascinatingly well. In your clip, you said ki mala ekdam click zalo, तर हे क्लिक झालं म्हणजे व्हॉट एक्झॅक्टली हॅपन व्हॉट मोटिवेटेड यू टू टेक अप युअर सायक्लिंग अँड देन प्रोग्रेस ऑन टू रनिंग कॅन यू शेअर दॅट विथ अस प्लीज
काय मुळात माझी तब्येत कायम चांगलीच होती पण 50-55 वर्षी असं ऐकलं होतं की कोणाकोणाला दुखणी येतात वा आणि त्यावेळी आमच्याकडे आमचे मित्र सायकलने आले आणि त्यांनी सायकलचं इतकं कौतुक केलं की मला वाटलं अजून उत्तर काही होत नाही आहे पण इथून पुढे 20 वर्ष जर काही व्हायला नको असेल तर लेट मी स्टार्ट
मॅम माईक घेत हां
अच्छा मला वाटलं माझा आवाज बिईंग अ लेक्चरर इज सो ओके सो आय थॉट दॅट फॉर कीपिंग माय सेल्फ फिट फॉर नेक्स्ट 20 इयर्स आय शूड स्टार्ट डुईंग समथिंग अँड देन आय लिटरली टूक द सायकल ऑफ माय नीस विच वॉज लाईंग इन द गार्बेज फॉर 20 इयर्स अँड देन आय स्टार्टेड विथ दॅट जस्ट वेंट टू डेक्कन बिफोर दॅट राईट फ्रॉम 18 आय नेव्हर वेंट एनीवेअर विदाउट स्कूटर अँड इट क्लिक मी दॅट डे टू कीप फिट आय स्टार्टेड सायकलिंग and then that cycling for the first day 2 kilometers that now my highest is 210 kilometers now one day so that is the journey and in between I met all such like people so I started abs I started gym then I started jogging and all that alternate days I have managed even surya namaskar I do 108 sometime every once in a week So all this is to keep fit. That was the click.
Fantastic. Thank you so much, ma'am. I think we'll move to Prachi. Prachi, as a young mother, you've mentioned that you've taken a maternity break. And I know that there are a lot of young mothers in the audience here, some that I'm personally acquainted with. And they can relate to you at some juncture or the other. After this entire break that you took, yeah, what got you to get back to running, put on your running shoes and get on with it again?
So like I said in the video, once anyone has run a half marathon, they know what it feels like. And to get that feeling again, I mean, it's going to stay with you forever. So that itching was always there that I want to do this again. So I did that for a little bit after I had my first baby. But then the next one came soon after. So there was another. And having two kids just changes everything. But still, that, you know, that lingering thought that you want to get back to it, you want to do it. And luckily for me, I had a good support system. And so I could, you know, leave my kids with somebody while I went out to run. So it's important to find that. And if you can find that and find a running buddy, my running buddy is sitting here in the audience. But yeah, you know, find somebody who wants to run also and just get out there. And then, of course, Pune Running just got everything going and all their events and everything that just keeps you motivated. So that's how I got back into running.
Thank you so much, Prachi. Manisha, it was very refreshing to hear you talk up there because the lingo of the younger generation is so specific and it's very peculiar, yeah? I know that a lot of young girls your age who are studying in college would opt for maybe going on a diet or taking protein shakes in place of a meal, or go to the gym with branded clothes because that's the most in thing to do. And it's not as, maybe running on the roads is one of the most unglamorous things that somebody your age would look at. What has motivated you, somebody your age, because I remember that you mentioned that not too many of your friends or peers are doing it either. So what got you to doing it?
Actually, what had happened is ki, like in gym, there's one guy, I mean, like he's not dying right now in gym. So he did a full marathon. So when he was practicing, he just said that I'm going to 5 km and my 10 kg weight is reduced. So I was like, okay, it might reduce weight. So let's give it a try. So hence, he just okay, fine. But the thing is, when I actually started running, like that first 12 kilometers itself, and I was running in university and you know premises, it's all green. So I was actually enjoying that and running too. From that time I started and I started liking it. That's all.
Wonderful. Thank you. I think it was quite interesting to hear her talk that she spoke quite matter-of-factly that, yeah, I went to the university. My first run on my first day, I didn't even realize I ran 12 kilometers. So there are not too many people who can say that. So I think you were born with that little running genie inside you and you should stick with it. Fantastic. Zia, I think we'll move to you at this juncture. I think to say that your life story has been inspirational would be an understatement, because the first time I met you, I realized that there are all of us who complain about little pains and niggles, and we come up with the most creative bahanas to say why we wouldn't get up in the morning and go up running, or in the evening, or it's a long day, or whatever it could be. But you know, to get yourself to get to running post the medical condition that you had, and then again, you so casually said that, yeah, my first 42, I ran in 4 hours, 40 minutes, which is like a dream for so many who just train and train and train so that they can get a sub 5, you know, timing. It's just amazing. Can you share with us what got you motivated to use running as a medium to come up stronger from what your life had made you face?
Like I said in the video as well, is that I've always been physically fit. So it's not something that happened overnight. I've always enjoyed it. I like going to the gym. I like working out. But when I had, when I was detected with breast cancer, it obviously, as you can imagine, it shook my world. I had two young kids at that time. They were 7 and 3. And I thought, you know, that was the end of the road for me. I mean, you know, that is it. I'm going to die or whatever. You know, I mean, these misconceptions that you have. But I had a very good support system, my husband and my kids and my family, and I read a lot about the disease and, you know, finally understood that it's not something that is that scary. I mean, in fact, it is called best cancer because it is, you know, it is treatable, and I talk to a lot of people who have had it many years ago and still living, you know, strong and healthy lives. Well, anyways, after that I underwent chemotherapy, and that was... You know, I remember getting back onto the treadmill after my, I said, let me try and get back into some kind of shape. And I couldn't run even 5 minutes. I would be huffing and puffing and, you know, I'd have to stop. And I said, you know, I'm going to take it slowly. I'm just going to do it slowly. I'm going to get to, you know, I have to beat this. I have to, I never wanted to feel like I felt after chemo, you know, where you couldn't even walk or climb up a flight of steps because you're so weak. And that is what, you know, I said, I have to, you know, it was almost like something I wanted to do that I could look back in my life and say, you know, I did that. I want my children to be proud of it. I want, you know, me to be, say that, hey, I did something, I achieved something. And I set a goal for myself. So that was what it was. I said, you know, in 2010, when I finished, I felt like that. I said, 1 year, in 1 year, by the time I'm 40, I wanted to run a marathon. By my next birthday, I started training with this group, the Pune Marathoners Club. And like I said, within 4 months, got to a stage. And it's possible. It is absolutely possible. You don't have to be running for 10 years or, you know, 2 years or whatever. If you train seriously for 3 to 4 months, and really seriously, you can achieve it. And that is what, I mean, I just promised myself that that is what I was going to do, because I mean, I'm not kidding. When I would close my eyes, the only thing I could see was the finish line, you know, of that, I mean, the marathon, the Bombay Marathon. So it was like when I was running, I felt like I will not stop till I fall on my knees. I mean, that is what I told myself. And it was, you know, and I keep telling my children, it's like if you focus on something, you really want something really badly, anything, anything is possible.
So thank you so much, Zia. Thank you so much. Avanti, I think we'll come to you at this juncture. I think your life is a little different from the others purely with the background that you've always been into professional athletics. I think you were a national level swimmer, and like Shilpa said, I think you've always been somebody who's had a podium finish even in earlier days. I know a lot of people who have been professional athletes in their younger days, but once their professional life kickstarts, then their athletics takes a backseat. It goes on to the back burner. But there's something that has kept you going despite your pregnancy, and like you mentioned in the video as well, you have kept it going all the time. So what is your motivation? Is it just fitness, or there's something beyond that that's your carrot?
I think it's an addiction sometimes. When somebody trains for 2 and 3 hours a day, it's because he cannot stop doing it. Some people are made like that, really. Others have to make an effort. The fitness comes with only a little bit of pain and effort. She's talking about running full marathons. It must have been a lot of pain. It was a lot of willpower. But there is a lot of effort that goes into it. And then you hear about, medically speaking, you hear about, oh, he used to do Sinhagar twice a week, and She used to walk 4 kilometers every day, and still they have acute myocardial infarctions, and they have strokes, and they have medical illnesses. So what I realized is that your heart rate has to go above 100 and stay there for a good 30 minutes, and that's a good workout. It doesn't come with walking. If you just walk, anybody can walk. Walking becomes easy after running. But it's the running that actually gives you the aerobic capacity, endurance and strength. And another thing is anti-gravity exercises are recommended for women because they tend to get osteoporotic after a certain age, 35, 40. So swimming is not anti-gravity, cycling is not anti-gravity, it's running that's anti-gravity, and trekking, walking. But then for the aerobic fitness to come in, it has to be running again. So I think the motivation was actually a level of fitness to help me do triathlons. I always wanted to do triathlons. So that was it really, to keep a level of fitness which keeps you mentally and physically fit, to have the endurance as well. And that's what kept me running.
Wonderful. Thank you so much, Avanti. I think we focused on the first bit because sometimes even getting started with something is the most pivotal part of it. And once you begin, you know, waking up in that morning, that fraction of a minute where you're like, I want to give in to the sleep and the overwhelming sleep. But even getting yourself to start off with any physical activity, like Bhavya ma'am started with cycling, or most of you did with running, it's fascinating. I think the next part, what we are moving to, is once you've started, maintaining becomes the next part of the challenge, the next part of the story. And maybe each one of you has faced some or the other kind of deterrence or pitfalls as you've gone along, or challenges, so to say. I know a lot of young mothers who say, I have to make dabba in the morning, children have to be packed off to school, and I don't get time in the morning, to any kind of physical ailments that could have come up. So Manisha, I can possibly touch upon the video that you mentioned, because I think for each one, according to their age and stage in life, the challenges are of a different nature. And I think for you, you had mentioned that your father, for example, doesn't quite approve of you doing this. We would like to know how you've been able to find your way around this and continue with this anyway.
Well, about that, yeah, my dad don't like, because he's like, you should much more concentrate on studies. So nothing. The thing is, like in morning I used to go, he saw a bit decrease in me, like in figure wise. Huh? So nothing, like I started, and after that now, like sometimes when I go in morning, like yeah, when I did Hyderabad marathon, that time what had happened, I was not expecting, like my dad will be waiting for me at night, because I came at 11 o'clock by Shatabdi, and that time, like he was telling proudly to relatives, ki ka mulgi padali 21 kilometer and all, my mom was telling me all these things, he didn't say anything at all. So yeah, like from that time you can say like sort of traces of approval I got, but earlier it used to be like aapko karna hai to karo, like I don't support it. But then, like the way you know, regularity is there, accordingly, you know, the people get, what do you say, convinced. Yeah.
Wonderful. Thanks, Manisha. I think Bhavya ma'am, you will like to come in at this point, because when Manisha is saying that when your family gets convinced, they're okay with it, but convincing them, it becomes the first part of it. If you can share with us how your immediate family in your own house reacted to you taking up cycling and running, and because most women your age, we would say, "Atami kashila zate, kema grandchildren ayat ghari, I'll sit at home," but you got to doing something, and how did the immediate family react to it, if you can tell us?
एक गोष्ट हल्लीच्या साठीच्या बायका काशीला जायचं नाही म्हणत, त्या संसारातनं थोड्याशा बाजूला झाल्यामुळे सगळ्याजणी मिळून सिनेमाला जाऊया अशा गोष्टी करतात, पण ॲथलेटिक किंवा हे नाही करत. तर मी हे सायकल वगैरे सुरू केल्यावर खरं आम्ही घरात तिघंच, माझा मुलगा 90 साली बाहेर गेला, मरीन इंजिनियर झाला तो, त्यामुळे आम्ही दोघंच. तर या मिस्टर भाव्यांना असं वाटलं की काहीतरी खुळेपणा आत्ता तिच्या डोक्यात आलंय, 4 दिवस करेल सोडून देईल, म्हणून पहिल्यांदा त्यांनी इग्नोर केलं. मग जेव्हा मी आठवडाभरासाठी एका प्रांतात सायकलिंगला गेले, तेव्हा त्यांना वाटलं की हे जरा जास्त सिरियस व्हायला लागलंय. आणि मग एकदा दोनदा गेल्यावर दरवर्षी डिसेंबरमध्ये 1 आठवडा 1000 किलोमीटर, पुन्हा पुन्हा तेच काय करताय, बास झालं की मग त्यांनी एकदा डिसलाईक. पण मग त्यांना जेव्हा कळलं की हे थांबणार नाहीये, म्हणताना त्यांनी दृष्टिकोन बदलून, म्हणजे आपोआप मुद्दाम नाही, आता त्यांना त्याचं कौतुक वाटायला लागलेलं आहे आणि ते अक्षरशः कुणी आले त्यांचे मित्र ॲप्रिसिएट करतात की या खारदुंगला सायकलने जाऊन आल्या, पाचगणीला जाऊन आल्या. असं म्हणजे आय हॅव गॉट माय ओन आयडेंटिटी बिकॉज ऑफ कन्सिस्टन्स.
लवली, थँक्यू सो मच मॅम. प्राची, आय थिंक नो प्रॉब्लम. प्राची, यू मेन्शन्ड इवन इन युअर अर्लियर बिट इन द अर्लियर पार्ट ऑफ इट दॅट अ सपोर्ट सिस्टम अराउंड यू इज व्हेरी नेसेसरी अँड एज अ मदर दो यू आर अ होम मेकर आय एम शुअर देर इज अ लॉट टू जगल विथ वॉट इज हॅपनिंग. इन फॅक्ट मोर चॅलेंजिंग जस्ट गोईंग थ्रू डेली चोर्स विथ द चिल्ड्रन इज अ चॅलेंज इन इट सेल्फ. सो हाऊ हॅव यू बीन मॅनेजिंग दॅट अँड कंटिन्युईंग अँड स्टील ट्रेनिंग एव्हरी डे?
लाईक I tried, I started off running just once a week and I think that is how I got the ball rolling. But all these volunteer runners that run with Pune Running, they meet weekdays and they meet at 6 in the morning because all of them have to go off to work. But I can't do that because both my kids have to go to school, I have to get them ready and all that. So luckily for me, when I did the November 30th run, my husband decided to do the December 30th run with me, even though he didn't really have any training or whatever. And so since then, he has been running too. And so what happens is then after the kids have gone to school, then at 7:15, both of us get out to run. Not many other people will leave the house to run at that time in the morning, but because it's the two of us and because the kids are off in school, we can do that. And so that helps too. And of course, we have my parents also, so they watch the kids when both of us go out on Sundays to run. And I also use this as a way that to motivate my kids to, you know, to be fit. And so they feel that both our parents are running, so we are missing out on something and we need to be a part of this. So they are really looking forward to coming out and running with us. So sometimes we just make it a family activity and they get their bicycles along. Oh. And we are running and they are cycling. So it's a win-win situation for everybody. And so I think the key is to involve your kids in it. And that way, you know, they also learn the importance of fitness and they have fun while doing it. And you also get your workouts and you know, your fitness goals are also achieved.
Thank you, Prachi. Zia, since she already mentioned about the children and the spouse being involved in her journey of what is happening, I think your family has played a pivotal role in your entire journey as well. I think especially post-recovery. And when I think the first time we met, you said, when I had dedicated that I want to in 4 months train for the Mumbai Marathon, and that you said you would wake up every morning and you just go to the race course and the spouse and the children would take care of themselves kind of a thing. Can you take us through this support system at home?
Sure. So that was while I was training, and even now I continue to run. Avanti said, it is addictive. It is that runner's high. You know, it's like a drug. You can't just stop. I need a fix every other morning. My family absolutely, they saw, I think what happened is that I started running at, or I still run at 5:30 in the morning. So I get up at 4:30 and then, you know, do whatever, eat fruit or something, get ready. And by 5:20 on the dot, I'm at the race course. It's pitch dark, but I have somebody I run with. So I don't run completely alone. It's scary, but I do have somebody from the group will run with me. And by 6:30, I'm done. So I'm home and in time to wake up my children and get them ready for school because they have to be up by 6:45. Also, luckily, I have a really good maid who's been with me for many years. So, you know, we kind of juggle that. My husband is very hands-on. So again, very lucky in that. He's extremely supportive. He has also started running like her husband, although he feels a little intimidated to run with me. He won't admit it, but he, like, you know, we were on a holiday, we were in Mahabaleshwar, I just came back, and because I didn't want to run alone on the streets, you know, early morning at 5:36, he woke up and he ran with me. And what he does is he runs as much as he can, then he gets into the car and then he just follows me, or he takes a bike and he bikes behind me. So or throughout my training for my marathon, I must say, once we went to Rajasthan, and it was December last year, so
we were in Pushkar, it was freezing cold, the driver was with a blanket, you know, and we had hired this car, and my husband got up with me, he ran part of it, I had to run, I had to do part of my training, so I had to do my 15, 20 kilometers that day, and they kept, you know, driving 1 kilometer ahead and waiting for me to come. So, you know, we find there is always, where there's a will, there's a way. I mean, you can find ways. My children are extremely supportive. They think I'm going to win some gold medal every time mama's running. And my kids are, my older one actually, she's 10. She's gotten interested in running. So she has run continuously. She's run 4 kilometers. And she wants to, you know, run more. So I'm going to, you know, try and take her out on weekends and kind of instill that. Because I feel, you know, if the kids see the parents, they too will have, you know, they will adapt and they will also, become healthy people as they grow up and grow older. So that's what.
Thank you so much, Zia. I think you're blessed that you have a support system within the house and in your spouse, so to say. Not too many women are that lucky, because we know women who, their husbands basically tell them that I don't want you running on the roads because people will stare at you and that won't be good enough. And we have women in our running community, I think Sef sitting in the corner is testimony to that, where every time we are talking about running and we say people are ogling, and we have one girl in our group who says that men are going to ogle anyway, whether you're walking, you're running, or however well clothed you are, men are going to ogle at you anyway. So you may as well run and still get ogled at, rather than, you know, not, or it deterring you. Or even in our area, if I'm going on a late night run and I'm alone, the watchman on that road become your bodyguard over there. So I think it's you finding your way out of the situation where they support you.
That people do get used to it, you know, and I feel like when they see you running, they see it once, twice, they look third time, achha, you know, it's a thing. I think what we're doing is we're doing service to our society by being out there and getting men used to the idea that we are
comfortable with the fact that women are running out. Thank you so much, dear. Avanti, I know that your son has also completed his Ironman, and he has a role model in his own house with what is happening. And you've, I'm sure, had your own challenges as you've come through life. Is there any specific thing that you want to mention at all of what kind of challenges you have faced? Because you're managing a full profession as a doctor, you're managing a home and doing your professional athletics.
Fortunately, I've not had injuries or major setbacks, such words, so far. I think the fitness level keeps you fit and keeps all the illnesses away. Being physically fit is a big immune booster. It keeps away a lot of illnesses. It postpones diabetes, it takes away high blood pressure. It even reduces the incidence of cancer. Once in a while, that chance is always there, but the immune system of a body is really built well. So I've not had any setbacks really. My children feel proud of our achievements. So they look up to it and try to follow the example. So basically, like she says, I go to England every year and there are 80 women running. It's such a normal sight that nobody stares and nobody looks at them. But over here, there is the one and the two, and if they're wearing shorts and some nice outfit, it's of course a matter of pride for the person sure. running in it, but people tend to stare. So the solution to it would be women coming out in hundreds and running. Then men would not know who to stare at them running. So I think that this should not be a deterrent at all. I think more the runners, the better it should be.
Great, Avanti, thank you. I think since you brought up the medical aspect of it in your points right now, we can move towards the medical misconceptions that a lot of people carry, whether man or lady, both carry a lot of misconceptions related to the physical injuries or the aspect in their journey towards running. I think we'll go one by one again. If Prachi, at this juncture, I think you mentioned in your video that post-pregnancy, you wanted to get back to running, but you had an accident and you picked up a ligament injury. And even beyond that, you got back to running again. How did you find your way around it?
Just before I had my injuries, when I came across the Pune Running Facebook page, and I was, you know, going back and forth that, oh, I need to start running with them. I need to join this group. And then I had the accident. It's actually a ligament of the knee, which is a pretty major ligament, and I had to have surgery. I was on crutches. It takes about 7 to 8 months of aggressive physiotherapy to get back to normal function. But throughout that injury and the post-operative phase and everything, I kept watching on Facebook all those month-end events that Pune Running had and all those runners and everything. And that just motivated me so much more to get out of this state and get better. And so I followed the doctor's orders to the T. I did the physiotherapy like they told me to do, and I was told to wait exactly for a year to regain function in the knee, and that's what I did. And then I started really slow. So I think it's important to listen to your own body, and because your body tells you if something is not feeling right, you will know. So as long as you listen to that and keep running, it should be fine. So that's why I don't push myself too much now. Although I am quite the overachiever now, I've decided that at this age I don't want to get into any more injuries. So I decide my I'll go take it as it goes and run as much as I'm comfortable with. So that's how I've reached 15 kilometers right now. So let's see.
Great. Thanks, Prachi. Zia, in your recovery period, was there any kind of precautions you had to take or any kind of medical steps that you had to follow so as for you to get into an injury-free running immediately later?
Not really, actually, because they say, exercise. My doctor said, as soon as you can start running, or whatever you want to do, please go ahead, especially because with breast cancer, I have to take some medication, which I still do, which actually depletes the calcium in the body. So osteoporosis is the side effect of that medication. So to beat that, actually, exercise is extremely, good, whether you're running, whether you're doing weights or whatever it is. In fact, that is what the doctor would prescribe to get over or to overcome any kind of osteoporosis or this calcium loss. Because before I started running, the only thing the doctor made me do was a bone density test because he wanted to keep a check on what the medication is doing to me. Knock on wood, I'm doing perfectly well. And I think, it's because of my fitness levels or whatever that I've been, there haven't been any kind of other setbacks at all. So there hasn't been anything that they've told me to not do. As long as I can do it. And, like she said, you have to know what your body, how it feels. It's not like I can run every day 20, There are some days I'll do 10 and some days I'll do 5. But you have to understand how you're feeling that day, not push yourself too much. You have to take it gradually and move ahead.
Thank you so much. Yeah, go on. Please.
I would like to add one thing though. While I was recovering from this knee thing, I was told that in order to keep the damage to your joints the minimum, you have to keep your muscles really strong, and especially when it's knees, your quads and your core or your abs have to be really strong so that they take the brunt of the impact, and the knees are saved. So that's also why I go to the gym now and work out to strengthen all those muscles, so that also helps keep the joints a little safer.
Great. Thanks, Prachi. Manisha, is there anything that you have faced in your journey into running where achy legs or any joint related issues that you
have? Yeah, like post running effect, everyone faces that. So that's the only thing which I faced. But if you stick to your schedule, I'm talking about workout, so you come out of it.
Wonderful. So you are following a schedule, somebody has worked it out for you that you're sticking to? Or?
Yeah, actually I go to gym. So only like on Mondays, instead of two sets, I just do one. That's it. That's the only thing which I do.
Great. Thanks, Manisha. Bhavya ma'am, you mentioned that you started into this much later with your cycling and your running. But was there anything that you were doing the rest of your youth or through your entire working career that helped you take up cycling or running so effortlessly and you continued with it? Were you doing any yoga regularly or anything to keep yourself fit otherwise?
No, I didn't do anything. वडिलांची अशी शिकवण होती की अभ्यास अभ्यास आणि अभ्यासच करायचो आम्ही, त्यामुळे दुसरं काहीच केलेलं नव्हतं. पण माझे वडील जोर हजार वगैरे काढायचे आणि माझी आई पण एकदम फिट होती, त्यामुळे ते माझ्या रक्तातच होतं. म्हणजे मी कधी एक्सप्लोअर केलं नव्हतं, पण जेव्हा करायला लागले तेव्हा ते असल्यामुळे मला ते आपोआपच जमलं.
वंडरफुल. थँक्यू मॅम. Avanti, I think the spotlight will be majorly on you regarding the medical misconceptions that most people carry. There are specific things that we had asked people and that came up. One was anything related to joints and pains, even as the women here were mentioning, osteoporosis, osteopenia, that is there, anything that man or lady can do so as to avoid going that path at all?
Yeah, that's true. In women, after menopause, say after 45-50, they tend to start losing the bone. The bone becomes less dense, and then because the hormone levels go down. So it is even more important for women to continue with anti-gravity exercises like running or trekking, which maintains the bone density. The muscle pulls on the bone and the bone keeps strengthening at the site of the pull. And that happens only when you walk or run or climb hills, Tekri, or climb Sihagad, or some anti-gravity exercises. The others like swimming and cycling do not have so much bone strengthening. Apart from that, you should also take calcium and vitamin D, which is important to keep the muscle, the bones. And for youngsters, I don't think it matters at all. They should get into the running schedule gradually, not run marathons straight away. But for young people, even if they get a lactate buildup and muscle pain and muscle cramps the next day, it is a good pain. It wears off in a day or two. They can continue with their activities despite the pain. And for the older people, when they do have wear and tear of the knees, and running along with core strengthening and quadriceps strengthening will all act as adjuncts to helping you run. So cycling along with running would help keep the thigh muscles strong to support the knees better. So the two complement each other, cycling and running, or trekking and running, or trekking and cycling. These are all complementary activity, which is partly the reason why doing triathlons is very helpful. Changing the activity and having a schedule over the week with changed activities also helps if the knees start grumbling if you run at a stretch every day of the week. So the activities can be changed every day, and that will help you run better for a longer period of time. So as far as osteoporosis is concerned, yes, women should continue to run or do some anti-gravity exercises to prevent it, especially so after menopause. And in addition to that, if there is stretching and core strengthening like yoga or Pilates, then it helps even more to run. Quadriceps strengthening and hamstring, some form of gym activity also does help in maintaining that running fitness for a longer period of time. Eventually, there is a wear and tear on the knees, so I think you should consult your doctor and also be up to date with supplements, especially vitamin D and calcium supplements for women. Apart from that, it's safe. People are running at 80, 90 and 100 also. And if they're running in a proper technique called chi running or whatever the techniques are, they can manage to continue running for a very, very long time. You should not overdo it, but doing it in a moderation is fine, actually, whatever the age.
Wonderful, thank you. I remember in one marathon, since you mentioned that 80 and 90 year old people are running, there was a lady who was wearing a t-shirt that says, "I'm 80 and I'm ahead of you." Yeah. So her t-shirt at the back was carrying it, "I'm 80 years old and I'm running ahead of you in the marathon," which, you know, gave a kick to a lot of people who are running. They had a laugh about it and, you know, they were competing with her. But like you're rightly saying, age sometimes is just a mental barrier for them to keep going. There was one question that specifically came with respect to anemia and varicose veins. I think it could be owing to the diets we have nowadays or the lifestyles we lead. Anemia is on the rise. Is there anything where, would anemia be a deterrent? Would it increase when people are running, or would it actually help come out of it?
Anemia is quite common, actually, more so in women because they have their monthly periods and they lose a lot of iron. And because our diets are vegetarian, there is not enough iron and B12 supplementation. So it's best to consult the doctor, find out what type of anemia you have and correct it. But exercise by itself improves the hemoglobin, because the tissues need oxygen when you're running. Because the tissues need oxygen when you're running, the body gets set into a metabolism to utilize whatever you eat. So if you're taking even a small amount of iron, B12, vegetables, fruits, everything gets absorbed. it's like a very effective plumbing system comes into place when you're running. Plumbing is circulation. So if the circulation to your gut is proper, then everything gets absorbed more so. So whatever supplements you're taking, iron or B12, they get absorbed better, and the anemia.
Avati, I think we'll just have to wait a second. Sorry to interrupt you, but because he needs to.
And because they have their periods and they lose a lot of iron every month, and the replacement is not adequate enough. So it's best to get it checked and correct it according to your doctor's advice. If there's iron deficiency or B12 or vitamin deficiency, it can be corrected easily. But running is not no bar for somebody who's anemic. Once he is on treatment and with a hemoglobin of as low as 10 and 9, people can run. They can run full marathons, half marathons. In fact, Anand did a blood donation. Anand Chakle over here. He did a blood donation before last year's Pune marathon. And 2 days, I think, after the blood donation, he ran the whole half marathon without any problems. So you can run, but with running, in fact, the anemia corrects itself much faster, provided you're on supplements. But even if there is an adequate nutritious diet, so anemia is no bar to running. The circulation to the stomach and the intestines improves so much that whatever supplements you take or whatever diet you take gets absorbed much faster, and the anemia corrects itself more easily with exercise. So that's not a problem. As for varicose veins, a person may have leg pain related to the varicose veins while he's running. But if he uses the proper TED stockings, the calves will act as muscle pumps, like an additional pump. And the veins will collapse and there will not be any trouble. So varicose veins is not a contraindication for running, though it is not advisable to stand in one position for a long time. Just standing for hours on end is not advisable. But that can be treated surgically and medically, and then the running can continue.
Great. Thank you so much on that, Avanti. I think we've established how each one of you started with your journeys, what your pitfalls were, and what medical issues you all have had, and you all have moved around it. I think if you're looking at the last bit of it in terms of how one can make a safe start into running, Prachi and Zia, I think if either of you can touch upon, or even Manisha for that matter, can touch upon how running with a group has motivated you all, rather than, you know, solo running, I feel, takes a lot of self-motivation to get out there and get yourself to run all by yourself. Whereas running with a group, how it has helped you, or how those of, maybe there are some people who are sitting here who just started running, and what's going to help them keep going, if you all can just alternately take us through it.
So I'm a part of a group called Pune Marathoners Club. And they are online. I mean, you just have to, and they keep post. So we have someone who trains us, actually, who has, you know, tells us about our diet, about how much we need to run that week, depending on the goal, in the sense, if you're planning on running a half or a full. So, you know, we all have goals, personal goals. Some are not. I mean, some are not running any marathon, but then, you know, so it's tailor-made for everybody. So we do run in a group, and for me that works really well. I mean, I love running with other people. Alone, like you said, it's very difficult to get motivated. So that is one, like I said, we run at the Pune race course. And on Sundays we do like a long run, which is outside. So that again, the route and, you know, the location is all pre-decided, and we get to know, you know, online. You just have to go on to their website and they tell you where to go. So that has really helped me running with the group.
Thanks.
Yeah, same here. I run with the group at the university, and you know, just having some of them have been running for a while now, so they keep motivating you. They tell you, you know, what's the way to go forward, or how you should increase, and just talking to them and running with them helps. And I think for me, one of the main things was doing, Pune Running organizes those month-end runs. So it's almost like a, you know, proper race or event that happens. And that atmosphere really gets you going. And to have all those volunteers along the way cheering you on and, you know, getting you going even when you really want to quit. So I think that helps you. And pushes you to go that extra mile and motivates you to do better at the next event. Not better than someone else, but better for your own, you know, what you want to do for yourself. So I think that is what motivates me.
Yeah, like running in group, mostly I run with my sir. Like he's sitting here itself, Vikasa. So like, it's like, you know, he pushes you, like when you feel tired or sometimes like, nahi sir nahi hoga, nahi nahi chalo chalo. So you know, it's actually fun, and when you match the steps and sometimes, you know, you go ahead. So you feel actually very happy. So it's actually like, yeah, it's actually very nice. I feel very happy when I, you know, running with a group. And even you don't feel anything, like even though if you have crossed kilometers, you don't feel tired also.
Very nice, thank you. Bhave ma'am, tu mi jeva cycling la jata, kema when you are running or your outdoor activities that you are doing, you have a group of friends you go with or some organizations you go with, how are you connecting with like-minded people to keep you going?
आमचं पुणे सायकल प्रतिष्ठान आहे, त्याच्याबरोबर आम्ही महिन्याच्या पहिल्या रविवारी टू प्रमोट, आत्ता जे आपण करतोय ते इतरांना सायकलिंग करावं असं वाटावं यासाठी करतो, आणि मग वर्षातनं एकदा आम्ही लॉंग डिस्टन्स करतो. पण आमचा ग्रुप म्हणजे चांगले 3-4, आणि आजच मी रविवारी गेले होते तर मला 25-30 मुलं तरी सायकलिंगला जात असलेली, रविवारी तर सगळेच पळणारे सायकलिंगमध्ये पुष्कळ दिसतात. आणि मोठा 400 लोकांचा ग्रुप आहे, पण दरवर्षी जेव्हा आम्ही करतो एका प्रांतातलं रनिंग, त्यावेळी 20-25 जण तरी असतो. आधी बुकिंग करतो ह्याच्यावर, मग ट्रेनमध्ये सायकली घालून त्या प्रांतात नेतो, आणि मग तिथून रोज आमचं शेड. आणि आमचं हे सगळं करणारे आमचे ते ऑर्गनाइजही करतात. एक दिवस मला आठवते राजस्थानमध्ये, त्या दिवशी आम्हाला लवकर हॉटेलवर पोहोचायला पाहिजे होतं, नाहीतर आमचं बुकिंग कॅन्सल झालं असतं. सगळ्यांच्या पुढे जात होते, आम्हाला त्यांना कॅचअपच करता आलं नाही 80 वर्षाचे असून. त्यामुळे असं आम्ही ग्रुपमध्ये जातो, त्याच्यात जास्त मजा येते.
थँक्यू सो मच मॅम. Avanti, I think earlier we were discussing that there are a lot of sports which are quite heavy on the pocket because there's a lot of investment that needs to be made, and maybe running or trekking are sports where you need minimalistic investment. It's just a pair of shoes and you don't even need specifically branded clothes. Is there anything on the clothing front or in terms of shoes that you would like to mention to the audience?
I think running that way is one of the cheapest sports really. You don't need a fancy cycle, you don't need swimming suits need to be changed every 6 months because they wear out in chlorine. Running shoes should just be comfortable. It keeps changing every time, with support, without support, Asics, branded shoes, but I think just a pair of shoes which are comfortable are good enough for a decent run. And for women, I guess they need a little support. They should wear sports bras and things so that they don't have any awkward running experience.
Sure.
But apart from that, it's just dry fit t-shirts and shorts and a pair of shoes. That's all you need.
Wonderful. Thank you. I think our panelists have been testimony to the fact that whether it was cycling or running or whatever it was doing, it was basically getting out there and physically doing something, whatever that it was. At this point, we can open it up to the audience in case you all want to pose any questions to the panelists at all. Anyone has any question? Yes.
Hi,